Boris Effects Continuum 2025 now includes support for Fusion inside of DaVinci Resolve. I'm here to walk you through a workflow on how you can get the most out of Continuum-based effects in your Node page, working with Primatte Studio, as well as BCC plus ColorLink. Let's get started. So I happen to be in the edit page of Resolve, where I have two clips that I'm going to be working with. So I have a green screen plate on video 2, and I'll just disable that to reveal the background plate on V1. One option for sending these over to Fusion is to select both of these clips, right-click them and choose to create a new Fusion clip, which will automatically merge these two together. However, there's a different workflow that we'll be using now. I'm going to head over to the Fusion page, and I want you to see that Media In 1, referring to my clip on V2, happens to be already piped into the Media Out 1, which is why I see my green screen clip in the screen here on the right. Now, first off, I'm going to head to my media pool, where I can grab my background plate and just drag this directly into the nodes area. Here, this is Media In 2. I'm going to connect these two elements by using a merge node. So I'm going to head over to my effects tab, and here under tools, at the very top, I can do a search for the word merge, where I'll find the merge node. I'll just drag that here into my workspace. The yellow triangle refers to my background plate, which is going to be my Media In 1. And my foreground plate is identified by Merge 1 Foreground. So I'll connect the Media In 1 to that, and then connect the merge to my Media Out. In order to see the merge in my right view, I'll make sure that it is being fed into the right monitor, so we can see the results of after we add our green screen keyer to Media In 1, the result of how that's going to merge and mix into our background plate. So all Continuum effects are going to be in the Open Effects section. I'll just expand on this so that we can see all of the categories. And we're going to head over to BCC, our Key and Blend category. And just to see everything inside of here, I'm going to clear the search results, where we'll find BCC Primatte Studio. Since I want to apply this green screen studio effect to my green screen clip, I'll add it to the branch in between Media In 1 and the merge. By default, Primatte Studio does nothing, but we're going to be monitoring all of our changes between the combination of these clips because Merge 1 is currently active. So with Primatte Studio selected, I see all of its parameters here in the inspector. And the first thing that I'm going to do is click on this large auto analyze button. It's going to take a look at all the green within the shot and try to remove it. In order to see the job that it did, the current matte status, we can just click on view current matte with the default settings of our sampling shape set to point and sampling mode set to clean background noise. I can continue to identify areas that are supposed to be background and just simply drag over them. Another tool option I have besides point is the sampling shape of rectangle. And I'll just try to sample more pixels here on the lower part of the shot. In addition to cleaning background noise, a ton of options here from this drop-down menu, including just cleaning up foreground noise. I'll just sample a few pixels there in our main subject. And once finished, we can just view the current matte to see how everything is together. I'll try to clean some more background noise here with my rectangle tool and also introduce some secondary spill remover to remove that green spill on my foreground and a little bit of the halo that's left behind him. Now we're going to add one additional effect to this pipeline to get a sense for what we can do here in Fusion. And that's a newly introduced BCC effect called ColorLink. So I'll just head to the top of the search field here and do a search for color link. I don't see anything because I have my BCC key and blend category selected, but if I go to the select all open effects, I'm able to see that. I'm going to add this to the tree just after Primatte Studio. Now, BCC color link involves a few different inputs. Okay, so right now we can see here that Primatte Studio is going to be the effect source. And what we're gonna do is sample color from the background media in plate. Now, in order to set this up, I'll pipe media one to the green triangle, which is the sample input. Now that our sample input is connected, I'm gonna make sure that I have color length selected so I can see its properties in the inspector, as well as that I'm still monitoring my merge one. Inside of color link, what we can do is set up from various sample methods. I'm gonna just choose the brightest sample method so we can see what it's currently grabbing from the background shot, as well as change the blend mode to be looking at the brighter pixels. So I'll just choose screen, noting that this is way too strong, and I'll bring this opacity down quite a bit. And then we can even add other effects such as a film glow, as well as color correction to get our desired look. Now that this is all set up, I'm gonna head back to the edit page so we can see our final look. I spent a bit more time on the keying process within Primatte and perfecting color length to show you this final result and what's possible. So there's a walkthrough of how we can use BCC Plus tools inside of DaVinci Resolve's Fusion page. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to subscribe and check us out at borisfx.com.